εάν δεν έχουμε να προχωρήσουμε στην επόμενη εισήγηση. Η οποία είναι του κυρίου Πλεμένου, ο οποίος δεν είναι εδώ, ούτε με το Skype μπορούμε να επικοινωνήσουμε. Και για το λόγο αυτό την εισήγηση θα την διαβάσει η κυρία Τσέγκα.
We can start. Ecclesiastical music and folklore research towards the revival of an old relation. The next slide, please. The first one. Slide one. Yeah. The relation of ecclesiastical music and folklore science is almost a self-explanatory, albeit a little studied case, at least in the Greek context. This is due to the fact that most folklorists are not musicians and most musicologists are not seriously involved with folklore, preferring instead more modern forms of academic specialization, such as social anthropology and ethnomusicology. However, until the 1960s, music folklore as a term and content too was still prevalent in European epistemology, the Greek one included. But as the music folklore has been identified with nationalist movements, mostly of Eastern European and Balkan countries, it began to be abandoned and replaced by ethnomusicology or musical anthropology. It is true that folklore has as its main concern the study of national cultures, unlike the social anthropology which extends to other cultures and traditions. So the anthropologist was reluctant to investigate her own culture, upon the idea that as ingenious, he or she may be preoccupied or biased in a positive or negative way. However, in recent decades, the social anthropology has focused on so-called home cultures, i.e., those belonging to the environment of the researchers, provided, of course, the latter's compliance to certain academic requirements. Next slide, please.
Maybe this is the next slide.
Slide two.
Maybe this
okay,
is already.
Maybe.
Let's see.
Maybe
what's
this is my. Yeah, yeah. In Greece, music folklore has been cultivated by well-known and reputable musicologists. One of the oldest, sorry for this mistake, one of the oldest being Melpo Melier, if I pronounce it.
Melier.
Okay. Who introduced the term in her essay "Musical Folklore in Greece" in 1935. Then next slide, slide three. Melier founded the Musical Folklore Archive in Athens, bearing today her name, and was also involved with church music, collecting, among other stuff, church recordings that were recently released in Greece. The latest development in ethnomusicology restored both the forgotten and misunderstood music of folklore and the relation of folklore science and research with church music. To be fair, folklorists have studied and also still studying and are also still studying other forms of ecclesiastical tradition and art that interact with popular culture, such as religious calendars and festivals, the ecclesiastical painting and wood carving, etc. There is also the branch of religious folklore that has experienced considerable growth over the last decade in Greece through scientific publications and presentations by well-known Greek folklorists. In this context, church music as a subject of Greek folklore remains a desideratum. Yet, where does this need arise from? How can church music be included organically in a discipline studying popular culture? One answer is that quite often the performers of folk music are themselves priests, cantors, and have an elementary knowledge of Celtic art. To use an example from my personal experience, a traditional violinist of a small village is Messenia serves until today, despite his age, almost 80 years old, a cantor of his local church, and at the end of an interview he offered to recite some church melodies among the most demanding communion hymn. That is why folklore is often used to record or write down ecclesiastical melodies by folk singers. To this, it must be added the so-called paraliturgical hymnography, which, although satirical, is part of the wider religious tradition of a place. In the archive of Hellenic Folklore Research Center of the Academy of Athens, one can find hundreds of Celtic recordings from older and younger researchers received during their official expeditions in various parts of Greece. Slide four. It also started in the early post-war years with the presence of the late Spiros Peristeris as a musical researcher in the Folklore Archive, now Hellenic Folklore Research Center of the Academy of Athens. It is noteworthy that the Folklore Archive, founded in 1918 by Nikolaos Politis, the founder of Greek folklore, housed a national music collection, I quote, for rescuing and collecting songs, dances, and musical instruments of the Greek people, end of quote, which was later absorbed by the music department. In 1937, the musician of the folklore archive, Thrasivoulos Georgiadis.
Thrasivoulos Georgiadis.
Okay. I really need help. Presented a memorandum, I quote, on the organization of the music department and the acquisition of the appropriate equipment for the mechanical recording of folk melodies, end of quote. In 1939, the archive acquired the phonograph, Telefunken, which was not used due to the declaration of war. Slide 5. It all changed in 1950 when Spyros Peristeris, first counter of the Athens Cathedral and teacher at the Athens Conservatory, was employed by the archive. The folklore archive acquired the magnetic tape recorder, where the wax cylinders were transferred to, and in August 1951, the first folklore mission was conducted in Ioannina. Ioannina, okay, northwestern Greece.
Okay.
In which Peristeris was accompanied by the late folklorist Dimitri
Economidis.
Okay. Note that at the same time, the Greek-American philologist Dimitris Notopoulos was in Greece with his own machinery to collect folk songs from various parts of the country. Okay, next slide. Peristeris went through many parts of mainland Greece, Peloponnese, Macedonia, Epirus, but also the islands, Kyatos, Rhodes, Kos, where he recorded, along with the folk songs and tunes, a number of church melodies by local cantors and priests. His status as first cantor of Athens Cathedral and teacher of Byzantine music at Conservatory of Athens gave him the right to undertake this mission and greatly helped him to approach his informants, who thought of themselves honored to sing for him. Even today, his passage has left its traces in older informants who remember their interviews with him with nostalgia and assert that his presence was a catalyst. His acceptance was greatly assisted by the broadcasting of the Sunday services from the Athens Cathedral by the state radio. Next slide. Peristeris was quite diligent in his recordings as well as in his comments with which he accompanied them. To this day, it is a common practice for the researchers of the Folklore Center to transfer all the recorded material from the field to large notebooks, which are today typed on the computer but were formerly handwritten. Peristeris was consistently notes down the age, origin, and education of the informants' records, while his sound is usually of high quality, clear by the standards of the day. Sometimes the identity of the informants as cantors or priests is almost apparent even from the interpretation of folk songs, a fact that Peristeris took care to note down. It could be added that Peristeris had begun the creation of an audio archive for ecclesiastical music, which he did not manage to complete. Slide 8. The significance of church cantors and priests for the preservation and dissemination of traditional music, as well as the need for folklorists to include church melodies in their recordings, has also stressed the late Greek musicologist Simon Karas. The main difference between Karas and Peristeris was that the former did not care so much for the recording of church melodies from folk singers as for the interpretation of folk songs from cantors and priests. However, in his teaching method of ecclesiastical music, which he considered as one of two branches of the overall Greek music, he included several folk songs which he placed at the sections of the ecclesiastical echoi. The method of Karas, despite some reactions, contributed to the rapprochement of ecclesiastical music with popular culture. The recordings of ecclesiastical music in the Hellenistic Folklore Research Center. In this chapter, I have gathered some important recording moments of ecclesiastical music from called folklore expeditions. One of the first ecclesiastical melodies Peristeris recorded with Philips was in 1955 in Kozani, Greek Macedonia, by the priest Dimitrios Hatsios. Okay. Who performed with great skill the troperion of the Saturday of the Akatist hymn, the great general in slow hermological melos. This melody is different from the one from the Mount Athos, using the same text, which was transcribed by Georgios Strigas in his Melodies of Skiathos in 1958, and recorded by the Greek Byzantine choir, conducted by the late
Kurgos Angelopoulos.
We have a
okay,
double.
So we can listen to it.
We have a double presentation, oral presentation.
Okay. Κάτι δεν έχουμε.
You want?
Just a minute. Μήπως καλύνει και να στο δώσω να το παίξεις από εκεί. Κοχωσιστικά εκεί. Κοχωσιστικά εκεί. Το έχουμε περάσει, ναι.
In 1956, Peristeris recorded in Corfu with the same Philips tape recorder a series of troparia from the Divine Liturgy of St. Chrysostom by Georgios Moraitis and his polyphonic choir according to the Heptanesian musical style and accompanied by an organ. The recordings include Holy God, We Praise Thee, One Saint, Praise the Lord, Communion Hymn by Nikolaos Manzaros. Composer of the Greek national anthem and Apolitikion of Saint Spiridon, patron saint of Corfu. Then this is
so
the next
maybe
line.
This is the next line.
In 1960, the music researcher of folklore archive, Stavros Karakasis, accompanying the then director of archive, Spiridakis, recorded in Aigilousa of Cyprus from the cantor Themistocles Patsiotis, a religious hymn that was common at weddings and baptisms. And this is a quotation: "To Thee, the Creator and Maker of everything, we sing prayers for Your many graces, O Immortal God, Creator in the high. Thou make the light and has adorned us prettily, guarding the health and utmost happiness the newlyweds, the best men and women, and everybody present." Next slide, please. The melody and lyrics has been transcribed and published in the music collection, musical selection of various songs by Georgios Zografos Keivelis as a quote, song for the school, lyrics by teacher Kantopoulos, music by Misail Misailidis, first cantor of Smyrna. Next slide, please. Save for minor melodic variations, the only noteworthy difference of the two versions lies in the replacement of a certain line in the earlier version referring to the founders and benefactors of the school with the newlyweds and best men and women. and women. It seems that the original school song has been arranged by Cypriots to fit the wedding or baptism context. Later in the same year, 1960, the late folklorist Dimitrios Loukatos recorded in Erikousa Island off Corfu Island the Megalinarion hymn of praise of Saint Spiridon by the chaplain of the local church, Antimosis Koutsouris. In 1961, Peristeris recorded in the region of Aetolia Acarnania, maybe it was better for you.
Okay, I just help with the names.
The Apolitikion of Our Lady of Prusos Monastery by Vasileos Papadopoulos, cantor in the Church of in Athens. Pretty productive was the expedition of Peristeris in Memphis in 1964, where he recorded, quote, various ecclesiastical melodies performed by acoustic tradition. From the old cantor, George Gidoyanos, 68 years old, he recorded the Irmos of the Ninth Ode of Christmas with the adjoined Megalinarion, as he had heard it from old cantors, accompanied by a drone. The same melody, Magnify My Soul with What a Strange Mystery, was performed by Evangelos Spataris of Kavala, 36-year-old, first cantor of Amphisa Cathedral, with great dexterity. The same cantors chanted two verses from the Magnificat of the first authentic mode. Gidoyanos began with the verse "Magnify my soul, the Lord," and Spataris went through, for he had looked down. Andreas Sisopoulos, 82 years, chanted the Troparion of Wednesday to thee, the Virgin Son, as, quote, he has learned it from the teacher and cantor Dimitrakopoulos. From the cantor and former Haralambos Theoharis from the Sphina, 39 years old, came the Troparion of the Great Lent, Open Me the Gates of Repentance, in second authentic mode, instead of the usual fourth plagal, as he had heard it from old cantors. Second song.
1 minute. Mm-hmm.
Haralambos Theoharis.
Το τροπάριο της μετανοίας άνοιξον μη πύλα ζωοδότα εις δεύτερον ήχον, όπως το είχε ακούσει από πολλούς ψάλτες.
Τι μετανοίας άνοιξον πύλας ζωδότα ορθρίζει γαρ το πνεύμα μου πρόσνα ον τον Άγιον σου. Espírito
Of some interest is the information of the song God Has Signaled, referring to the fall of Constantinople to the Turks by the merchant Gheorghe Calias, 70 years old, for which Peristeris noted that, quote, he has learned from a monk of the monastery Taxiarchae of Aegion, named Chrysanthus, in year 1930. It was a technique of Byzantine melody in the first plagal mode, end of quote. The lyrics incorporate another song of the same tragic event, an unfried fish, which, with while every stanza is followed by a crotema, non-syllable passage. Next slide.
So maybe this is next slide.
Uh-huh. Later in the same year, the late singer Domna Samiu recorded an extract from a gospel recitation, Holy Monday Evening, by a priest in Astipalea, who is not named. Quotation, if David calls him Lord, how is possible that he is his son? And nobody was able to answer anything, nor anybody dared from that day ask him any questions. That's finalis, followed by the melodic exclamation, glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee, that sings by, sang by Cantor. In 1965, the folklorist Gheorghe Ekaterinidis recorded in a neo-suli of Ceres the prayers and requests of the priest of the village Dimitri during the procession of the icons and placing of the holy bread in Easter period. Next slide. In 1967, Stavros Karakasis recorded the ringing of bells in Argostoli Cathedral of Kefalonia by the priest John Moskonas, escorted by his son. In 1969, Peristeris recorded in Skiathos Island a large number of church melodies from a tradition of the Holy Mountain, which will be discussed hereafter. Next slide. Peristeris' expedition to Skiathos. In Skiathos, Peristeris recorded two cantors and a priest. The first of the cantors, Michael Mitzelos, 66 years, who was also a local pharmacist, after he recounted, I quote, the history of the advent in Skiathos of monks expelled from Mount Athos who resided at the Evangelistia monastery, which they built. End of quote. He sang eight ecclesiastical chants, I quote, as he heard them from the old cantors in Skiathos, end of quote. Among these included are two works of the monks of the monastery, the Kontakion of the Feast of the Annunciation, the same substance with the Father and the Holy Spirit, according to the great general, and a Troparion, seat of Saint Haralambos, that who fought bravely according to that who has raised the, on the cross.
Νομίζω ότι πρέπει να σταματήσουμε γιατί έχουμε ήδη καθυστερήσει.
Okay.
Θα ήταν βέβαια ενδιαφέρον να ακούσουμε και αυτά τα περισκιάθου.
Άλλα παραδείγματα δεν έχει.
Δεν, έχει,
τα ηχητικά,
δεν έχει καταθέσει κάτι από την τελευταία εργασία
θα...
για, για τη Σκιάθο. Θα ήταν πολύ ενδιαφέρον να ακούγαμε αυτές τις καταγραφές και να δούμε πώς έρχεται όλη αυτή η παράδοση στις μέρες μας και ίσως να έκανα και μια πρόταση τώρα. Ίσως θα πρέπει να καταθέσουμε και ένα οπτικοακουστικό υλικό πέρα από τις εργασίες μας, να δώσουμε ένα οπτικοακουστικό υλικό ο καθένας ό,τι έχει παρουσιάσει στο συνέδριο αυτό.
Γιατί καλά θα ήταν.
Ναι, δίνουμε τις εργασίες μας, αλλά νομίζω ότι και το οπτικοακουστικό υλικό θα ήταν κάτι πολύ καλό να κρατήσετε.
Μπορώ να, να κάνω μια παρατήρηση.
Ευχαρίστω.
I think that the best recordings that are existing in the folklore archives of the Academy of Athens, the best, the better they are, the bigger the shame that they have not published them. It's very bad that these recordings are staying there, just collecting
dust
and mukhla, and nobody listens to them because they are so beautiful.
Yeah.
We must write it to Mr. Plemenos directly. Okay. But